fur, feathers, scales, skin. These are some of the most common forms of integument, at least in amniotes. Well, if you look at the Ophaur, it obviously has at least some of those things. We aren't exactly sure when fur evolved in therapsids, but due to more synapsid research and genetic analysis of the Ophaur, they seem to have evolved at the last common ancestor of all stereodonts, at least in this timeline. We don't exactly have an Ophaur of our own in our timeline to figure these things out. Now let's check out their skin, fur, and other features and see if they're anything special. There is quite a bit of variation in Ophaur fur. Of course, they can come in a variety of colors, but another thing to know is the texture and the length. Consider the North American Ophaur. Some of them live in much more frigid regions than other Ophaurs, which means that their fur is generally thicker than the others. In the winter, the fluff becomes truly extreme, with some Ophaurs getting an almost shaggy appearance in some parts of their body. The Ophaurs of South America have shorter fur, not only because they prefer warmer climates, but also because they're more likely to swim than other Ophaurs, with shorter fur reducing drag as they swim. Due to the Ophaur's extensive range, there are many populations that live in or near deserts. Generally, these populations have fur that keeps them cool in the day and warm at night. Of course, underneath the fur is skin. Ophaurs have skin that is typical of all synapsids. Smooth, glandular. The skin produces oils that are absorbed by the fur, which makes the fur water-resistant enough to repel rain that falls on it. The fur of the South American Ophaur is even more water-resistant, but it is still not on par with dedicated semi-aquatic mammals. Ophaurs have sweat glands on their paw pads, snout, and ears. This combined with the extensive blood vessels in the skin of their ear allows them to cool down on hot days. Now, Ophaur paw pads. If one were to zoom in on them, you'd see that they are covered in tiny ridges, and in offies, the ridges are far more pronounced. These ridges allow them to have lots of traction when it comes to scaling surfaces, and combined with their sweat, they can even climb vertical surfaces. Another purpose their paw pads have is to allow them to walk silently, similarly to a cat. Their back paw pads are almost reminiscent of the ones seen in marsupials, as the pad covers the entire foot of the Ophaur. And at last, the Ophaur rhinarium. Like most mammals, Ophaurs have a wet nose. The Ophaur's rhinarium evolved in parallel with the male's rhinarium from a kind of proto-rhinarium seen in eustereodont therapsids. As a result, they are not exactly the same structure and have notable differences. For one, the rhinarium of the Ophaur and its close relatives doesn't have a cusp like a mammal's. The rhinarium is also made up of less flesh than a mammalian rhinarium due to their nostrils not forming a single opening in the skull, which is why mammalian nostrils are usually like this, while borean nostrils are simple holes. And that's an overview on the integument of the Ophaur. Subscribe for more!